welcome to the arena, Chico Oliveira.
All right, Chico Oliveira, Superman.
Yeah, I'm excited to see what he brings to the table here tonight. Also fighting out of Dominion MMA.
Saw a lot of skill out of these Dominion MMA fighters. I know that Chico only has one fight as far as an MMA bout, but I believe he has some other fight experience.
Yeah, so for some of you, I'm sure many of you are probably familiar with the Street Beefs YouTube channel. They're a very popular glove up or shut up, as they say. Settle your beef in the yard, not on the streets. And so for those of you who don't know, it's not always just like straight beef fights at Street Beef. Sometimes people just want to go test themselves. And Mr. Chico Oliveira himself has appeared in the Street Beef yard and had a pretty quick win out there.
All right, so a couple of fights experience under his thing. And I believe this is a catchweight fight from what I'm trying to.
Yeah, these guys are fighting at 160. I'm not sure the precursor to that, why they're not fighting at a, you know, designated weight class, but whatever, they maybe just don't have to cut as much, and hopefully they're out there fresh and ready to put on a good show for us tonight.
Absolutely, absolutely. And his opponent actually fought in the last DFC. We'll get to that in a minute. But from what I understand, Chico, very aggressive in the pocket, a lot of forward movement in his fighting style.
Yeah, he likes to, he will lead with some leg kicks. He's not scared of doing that.
All right.
Monroe, Louisiana, welcome to the arena, Chris Velarde.
All right, Chris Velarde fighting out of Main Street Boxing in Muay Thai in Houston, Texas. Yes. Made his debut, lost it, but lost it to a high-end black belt grappler.
Yeah, he looked good out there. He's like Brock said, he had a very tough opponent in Mr. Dustin Leonard, who's a black belt out of Triad. And Chris Velarde rocking the cowboy hat again here. Familiar for those of you that watched DFC 3 with us. Bit of a character. He's fun to watch.
Singing along with the song, it seems like.
Yeah, bust his head this time. Last time he fought for us, he had some long, luscious locks he was rocking. And now he's got the buzz head look.
Now, would you ever have had long hair in a fight?
Oh, no, I had long hair after I retired, and no, it was too much of a pain even when I wasn't fighting, and no, I would absolutely never fight with long hair.
Retired?
Yeah.
I'm still trying to convince you. I don't know about all that. We'll talk about that after. Well, retired.
Maybe one day.
Just need more time.
It looks like his corner man has kind of picked up his hair.
Yeah, it does, actually.
Yeah, Mr. Velarde had the hair the man behind him is rocking last time he fought for us.
Looking very composed, looking ready.
Yeah, he looks good out there tonight. Yeah, I expect Chico Oliveira to maybe lead with some low kicks and maybe follow that with some punches. And we'll have to see how Velarde responds.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next contest is an amateur bout scheduled for 3 3-minute rounds in the 160-pound division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, entering tonight's matchup with one amateur bout, standing 6 feet even, weighing 160 pounds, fighting out of San Antonio, Texas, representing Dominion MMA, raise the roof for Chico the Superman Oliveira! His adversary, ladies and gentlemen, standing across in the red corner, entering tonight's matchup with one amateur bout, standing 5 feet 9 inches tall, weighing 161 pounds, fighting out of Houston, Texas, representing Main Street Boxing in Muay Thai, give it up for Chris Bovine Velarde! Third man in charge of the action, Josh Lee. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get it on!
All right, the bovine, definitely leaning into the bull. I will say at 5'9", 5'8", you're fighting in at 160 pounds. That's a very good height to weight ratio.
Yeah. Chico Oliveira, very kind of karate looking stance, and Chris Velarde with a clean
going for
double
the
leg.
Big double leg, lots of power there.
Quickly
used it to pass the guard.
Trying to pin the leg, or pin the arm, excuse me.
Keeping a very wide stance, sort of an MMA pass there, keeping low like that.
Definitely.
not quite a body lock because he has his arm behind his opponent's head there. That way his opponent can't turn away.
Yeah, nice reverse cross face.
And then going into an arm triangle pin. Is he going to try to go to the other side? It looks like he's trying to get his knee clear. Don't know exactly what his thoughts are there. And now he's on the side.
Yeah, good job.
He's on the other side of what the choking would be, and there he goes to go around it.
Yeah, use it to move into full mount. He has to protect his leg there, back into the half guard. He could cut to the other side here.
Yeah,
very nice leg pummel.
And leaning deep into it.
He's deep on that.
And that was the kick over.
Very close from Chico. Oh, he's fighting so hard for this. This might be it. Oh, it's so
close.
Oh,
that actually looked like it got deeper, but he's getting a chance to turn into his opponent now.
Yeah. Chico's arm is kind of above his face, so it's giving him a bit of reprieve. Looks like he might even be talking to his opponent, so that makes me think he may be okay here. But his face is a bit turning purple, but I think he's fine.
All right, so going back to the mount, which is a good thing about an arm triangle like that. If you have control and you know when to come back. Now he's going to try to gift wrap his opponent. Very old school move here.
Yeah, Velarde looking cool and comfortable in this top position. As he should be, but, I mean, he's doing a great job. That
heavy hand.
Yeah, he's looking clean here.
Not looking to score, looking to finish.
Yeah, that Olvera having some trouble here dealing with it, which is such a tough spot. I mean, one of the best things you can do here is turn to give your back. Basically follow your hand because you can't turn the other way. Yeah, sometimes you got to give your back and follow the escape from there. But Velarde lets go of it, but Olvera's still stuck in the mount here.
Yes, high mount, putting a lot of pressure on his opponent. When you see your knees splayed out like that, you're definitely leaning on the diaphragm.
Yeah, Olvera needs to really move from here. You don't want to just sit here and take
Yeah, not moving
punches.
Near enough.
Yeah, bridging, getting a knee in. He's got to make some more contact with Velarde. Even if he's not able to flip him over, he's got to kind of take away some of that space.
Now, I'm watching Velarde's footwork, which you may not think is a thing really from the mount, but it is. Notice how the feet are instantly going to the prayer position there. Definitely doing a real good job of keeping his balance as he throws these punches. Very well coordinated from here.
Yes.
Oh, nice little slam just to say you can't just hold my head.
Yeah, he looks very like experienced in this position. He looks very clean, solid technique.
And you're trying to use the wall to escape, but in the last 10 seconds.
Yeah, he halfway gets out, but the round's over. Very clean.
Round number one is in the books. Monroe, Louisiana, make some noise.
Maybe one of those occasions where you lose to a grappling technique in your previous fight. You maybe double down.
Yeah, I mean, his opponent's last fight, like we said, was a very legitimate black belt. So you don't expect to go against that in necessarily your first or your second amateur fight. So the fact that he had that experience, be able to learn from it and use some of that in his future endeavors.
Looking very good, very clean double leg. I can't say enough of, like, a lot of power, but not just pure power. Actually, a follow through with the technique.
Yeah, that was very impressive. Between the takedown, between the leg pummeling, the pass the guard, and then the security he had in the mount, like, you don't see that kind of grappling in the UFC sometimes. I mean, he looked very, very strong in this position.
Seconds out, please. Seconds out.
Here we go into round number
Ladies
two.
Ladies and gentlemen, round number two. Here we go.
What would you do if you were Superman?
I'd definitely be looking out for the takedown, maybe get a stance a little lower. And, you can't end up on bottom. He obviously couldn't deal with being on bottom. And,
ooh,
I mean,
big follow-through encounter there.
Yeah, Chris Velarde caught him on the feet already. So, I mean, got to find your shots if you're a Superman.
And I will say something that you brought up, and I'm looking at it now, and I agree with you. Sort of a karate stance coming from Mr.
Yeah,
Chico.
Yeah, very one leg forward and good strikes against the cage. But Velarde able to close that distance and reverse the position has – Superman kind of bent over here. Looks like he's probably going to secure this takedown.
And definitely has the feet between the legs, trying to switch around, trying to take the back to the – yeah, there we go.
He has the posture so broken. It was just a matter of time.
And now do you go for the back here?
Yeah, he's definitely going to get those hooks in at least one, I would assume. But Olvera does a good job getting his chest back down to the ground, taking the space, climbs up the cage a bit.
Very heavy on his opponent.
Yeah, he's still such broken posture. Looks like Olvera may be getting a warning there from the ref for grabbing the cage. Good knee from.
Again, trying to take the back, just ride his opponent down. Up, oh, is he going to climb him?
Yeah, he's like a leech right here, just all over.
Oh, and this, yep, simple suit play, but it works.
Yeah, you got to be careful if you're Olvera posting the hand down. Thankfully, there wasn't enough impact to hurt it, but
yeah, too many videos of arms being broken
I've
there.
I've been seeing it so much lately, people trying to stop that takedown with the arm post and just snapping in half. Thankfully, we didn't see that tonight.
All right, using a very good job.
I love what I'm seeing from Velarde here, knee behind the knee of his opponent to kind of turn him away. I'm not sure if that's intentional or not, but I've been using that a lot lately myself and use it
directly to the mount. Yep.
Yeah.
I believe you and I both actually kind of have a similar stance there.
Yeah, knee pinched into the hip there.
Using the foot. Oh, my God. Again, people, the footwork of Chris Velarde, I can't specify enough. That is actually very intelligent movements. Using a very wide base so that he doesn't get just bucked off.
Yeah,
walking his opponent away from the wall there.
Velarde's looking like a seasoned vet here tonight, man.
That's right. Velarde went back to the drawing board, ladies and gents, and said, it's not going to be the same way.
I love this posture. It's kind of just monkey punches, for lack of a better word.
But at the same time, the knees are staying, so it's all coming from the hips and the upper body. He's not trying to twist into a heavy punch.
Yeah. He's looking good here. Looking maybe for the arm triangle.
Looking for the arm triangle again. You can close it from the mount. You can do it from the mount.
And even if he doesn't fully commit to it here, he's kind of smothering his opponent with his chest and his arm. Like, his opponent's probably begging him to move somewhere else at this point.
That's right. A little bit of psychological warfare sometimes, just putting your chest on your opponent, making them try to breathe through you. And there we go. Again, that one's deeper looking.
Yeah,
that is very deep. Oh, he squirts out again, leaning into it. That has to be very tiring, though, looking into the arm triangle.
Yeah, Olvera's really struggling on bottom here. I mean, Velarde maybe doesn't finish here. There's only 10 seconds left in the round, but, I mean, he's had two dominant rounds.
I thought he was going to get a Peruvian necktie attempt there. I wasn't going to lie.
I wouldn't
I was
be surprised. Velarde's, oh, man.
Ladies and gentlemen, round number two is in the books. Monroe makes some noise.
Yeah, there was a moment there when it popped up. So, Velarde, we had him written down as a striker. He showed incredibly good striking, this time showing a very just deep intelligence.
I'm very impressed with his grappling, but Olvera not in bad spirits here. He's smiling in his corner over there, kind of laughing at the coaches, even after his two tough rounds. I wonder if they have a plan to try to bring this back in the third. I mean, you essentially have to have a finish here.
That's right. You have to go for broke.
Yeah. He cannot end up on bottom. He hasn't shown any indication he can escape from that position. I wonder maybe if he gets on top, if he can do anything, or if he can kind of keep the distance and look for some good strikes. But he essentially must find a finish if he wants to win this fight tonight.
Seconds out, please. Seconds out.
So a little bit of
Monroe, Louisiana, third and final round coming at you. Make some noise.
A little bit of the psychology of the third and final round, though. If you know you're down by two, you know you can go for it, right?
Yeah, and I'm imagining Chris Velarde's corner told him, you know, watch out for him coming out crazy here. He's, like, going to try to finish it. Looking for a high kick. Gives it a second thought as he's throwing it.
Didn't realize that Chico's face was a little more bloodied. Now that I stand it up, I can see it. Maybe the price he paid for turning into those arm triangles.
Yeah, and I think he caught some good punches there when Velarde was in the mount. His face is a bit swollen as well as bloody.
Chico very much seeming to be interested in distance and head kicks at this point.
Right, yeah, he's definitely trying to find his timing and try to land something big, it seems.
He's going to be going for broke with these head kicks.
The only thing is, he's not really setting it up enough, and Velarde is just able to see it coming so easily. He looks fresher, the fact he's been on top and been kind of just chilling up there. Olvera just kind of a bit sluggish in a sense, probably from, you know, having to fight off the bottom so much and taking so much damage.
And Velarde, I notice anytime his opponent's coming in, he seems to very much so sit in the pocket and come back up and out and around.
Yeah, he looks very comfortable and clean right there, kind of chin tucked down, hands up, good head movement. Really, I mean, good footwork, man. Kind of man crushing on Velarde here. I really like what I'm seeing from him.
Yeah, again, there it is. His opponent comes in. He just ducks in and goes for it.
Good exchange here from both guys.
Caught him on the way out. Velarde, I think, winning that exchange right there at that last strike.
Yeah, Olvera did land one or two there, kind of decent, which is better than he's landed so far. Oh, a bit of a low blow. It's unfortunate.
Accidental.
That's unfortunate.
Seeming to catch on the edge. It was always a small delay when it happens to the opponent. To this fighter.
Yeah. Unfortunate. It was completely accidental, but we're going to give Mr. Velarde a few minutes here, as long as he needs, up to 5 minutes to adjust himself.
That's right. You want to make sure you're back in the cup.
Yeah. You don't want that to affect you as you're restarting. You know, you want to be fresh. You don't want that to be a problem for you.
Absolutely. Chris Velarde so far looking great this fight. Small chance for a deep breath. Small readjustments before we get back in.
Yeah, still seems to be in some pain here, but hopefully he gets sorted out, you know. Hopefully no too long of lingering effects. Like I said, he has up to 5 minutes from the time the referee calls the time to start for the break. So
that's right. And in this case, for amateurs, that's actually longer than the round itself.
Yeah, yeah. So he should have time as long as there's nothing, you know, seriously medically wrong there. Should be good after a couple minutes here.
A small honest moment trying to adjust yourself in front of everyone.
Yeah, yeah. In front of the crowd, in front of the internet. It's recorded forever.
All right, looking deep. He said no glove touch. I think he might be a little upset by it occurring.
I'd like to see a little more setup from Chico here on those kicks.
Yeah, it's very much one-dimensional. The hands kind of stay in the same place, too, which I wonder if his coaches will address in the future. That karate stance, that low karate stance, that Wonder Boy, it's kind of difficult to pull off.
Yeah. Good little rock back into the 1-2 from Chico there. Doesn't land too clean. And it looks like he caught the elbow. A little slap sound on the kick, but it looks like he caught the elbow. Probably took more damage from it than he gave.
Now, I will say the leg of Chris Velarde starting to show a little wear and tear. Very patient there.
Yeah, nice.
Choosing his shot.
Kicked his leg out from under him, did Velarde. Into the top of the butterfly guard. Don't see it too much in MMA. Great.
Very good pass.
Great hip movement. Clean pass. Nice heavy weight until he decided to pop the hips over to pass it.
Chris Velarde showing a huge evolution to me as far as ground game.
Yeah, he's kind of unbelievable that he's 0-1 coming into this fight. Like I don't mean to sound too biased. I don't even know the man, but man, he's really impressed me here tonight.
Absolutely, can't wait to see him again.
Yeah, please show up for us at DFC 5. I'd love to call your fight. Olvera, I mean, he's got to move. There's not much time left in this fight.
And going for the Kimura key lock. It's popping out.
Yeah, Velarde, even though it looks like he's not going to finish this one tonight, I mean, he did everything but very clean. I would imagine it's got to be a 30-27 at least for him.
If not, a 30-26.
Yeah, it was, man, what a great performance.
Absolutely. So as we move on, this was the first fight that went the distance, but overall I would say dominant performance in my book by Chris Velarde.
Yeah, that was clean. I don't know if I'm able to catch up with him after the fights, man. I'm going to have a chat with the man. That was very nice, very fun to watch.
Absolutely. Showing me a lot of improvements. Several things I was impressed with on the ground.
Even on the stand-up, man, the head movement, footwork is clean.
Head movement coming in and out of the pocket. Absolutely. All right. And as we go to the scorecards, a few picture opportunities. Over halfway through the card tonight. Excellent fights all around. Even this one going a distance.
Yeah, we don't get too many decisions here at DFC. This is the first one of the night, and it was a fun one, in my opinion.
Absolutely.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecard for a final decision. All three judges score this bout unanimously for our winner, the red corner, Chris Bovine Velarde!
As expected, Chris Velarde getting the unanimous decision. Man,
that's right.
Props to both these guys. Chico Olvera did a great job at least hanging in there. I mean, Velarde looked